Close your eyes and watch your breath coming in, going out. Try to be with it all the way in, all the way out. As for what's going on outside around you, you don't have to pay any attention. Pay attention to your mind, because the mind is what makes all the difference. Today we're a little bit short of space. But when you're physically crowded, it's not as bad as being mentally crowded. Mentally crowded is when you're living in a situation where you can't find any happiness. Things seem to be pushing in on you from all sides. So you've got to look inside, because that's where true happiness is going to be found. It's not that you just simply accept things outside. You try to change what you can, but then you realize you bump into things that you can't change. So you look into your mind. Because the mind is what should be totally under your control, and yet for most of it, it's totally out of control. The mind should be like a home with windows and doors that you close and open so that you let in only your friends and you keep out people who might be harmful. And you yourself go outside only when there's a real purpose. And if you have anything bad inside, if you have any ferocious animals in your house, you keep them inside. You don't let them go out prowling around the neighborhood. In other words, we have to exercise restraint if we're going to find some happiness. So we say and do and think only the things that are going to be for our good and for the good of others. And things from outside that might be bad influences, we just don't pay them any attention. Things inside that may be harmful, we don't let them out. That's what restraint means. It means you keep some control over things. Now, control sometimes can get crowded as well, which is why we meditate to give the mind a sense of well-being. You breathe in, breathe out in a way that feels good. Try to think of the whole body breathing. Every part of the body is involved in the breathing. And that way you get a sense of spaciousness inside. So even though you're physically crowded outside, the inside there's a lot of space. Otherwise, greed, aversion, and illusion move in and they squeeze the mind. So you feel crowded into doing things that you're later going to regret. So this is one of the purposes of restraint, is so you don't do things that you're going to regret later, because you can't go back and change the things you've done in the past. But as for the decisions you're making right now, you can make a difference right here, right now. So focus your attention here. And don't let the unskillful qualities of the mind squeeze you into doing things that you know we shouldn't be doing. And leave the mind open for things that will be good and beneficial. Otherwise, our minds are like bus stations. Anybody can go in, anybody can go out. All kinds of things happen in the bus station. You want your mind to be more like a home, where you're in charge of who comes in, who goes out. And when they come in, you're still in charge. And John Cha has the image of a house with only one chair, and you're sitting in the chair. Don't let your greed get into the chair. Don't let your anger get into the chair. Because the person sitting in the chair is the one who's in charge. When greed and anger come, you can turn them away at the door. Even when good things come, you get them to do what you want them to. Because you're in charge. So this is why we meditate, is get some control over the part of our lives that we can gain some control over. So we don't feel squeezed inside, crowded inside. So even though the world outside may be crowded, inside is wide open and spacious. Because we live with our mind more than we live with the world, actually. So we make sure the mind is in good shape. That's the world outside. You help it when you can. When you can't, you come back in and make sure what you've got inside doesn't get harmed. That way you can go through the world safely.